So Chinese New Year is coming up in a couple days. And this is the year of dog! Come on, dude. So we want to talk a little bit about how you can put together a meal for a spring festival. Usually the biggest and the most important meal of Chinese New Year is held on Chinese New Year's Eve, which lands on 15th February this year. So the idea we're based off here and structured here, it's a southern style because I'm from Guangdong. So the first course is usually soup. Soup is a very important component in the meal and a nice start to give you a little taste of the meal. So after soup, it's usually LENGPAN. LENGPAN is cold dishes. We usually have stuff like luwei or white cat chicken, or roast meat is also very popular, like tasi, which is roast pork with sweet fermented bean paste, or xiuyou, which is roast pork belly with a very crispy skin on top of it. So coming up next is ZHUSHI. ZHUSHI are hot dishes. They're also the most impressive looking centerpiece of your meal. Around this time of year, the most traditional ones would be lamb stews or beef stews. What you can also do is lanzhai meatball. Those are tennis-sized pork meatballs that stew in stock for 4 hours. Or you can also do hongshaorou, red braised pork, which it's a big play of delicious braised pork. Everybody loves it. You can also do steamed sticky rice meatballs, which are pork meatballs that's coated in sticky rice after steam. It's very fluffy. So after the ZHUSHI, it's XIAOCHAO. XIAOCHAO means stir-fried. What you can do is you can just do a simple stir-fry. For example, like the clam stir-fry, it's a really good choice. It's got great color, nice taste. So it can be a good candidate for your stir-fry. But of course, any kind of stir-fry you want is fine. So a very important dish in the New Year's meal would be a fish. Usually in Guangdong, what we will have is a steamed fish because it's very tasty. The reason why fish is very important is that it's very auspicious. The Chinese word yu, which is fish, also means you have left or you have fortunes left. Usually that's what it means. So every year you want a fish in your New Year's meal. So after all those dishes, coming up next would be a starch. Usually it wouldn't just be a simple bowl of white rice. What we would like to do is make some fried rice. For example, you can make Yangzhou fried rice, which is very good looking because it has all the colors. It's also very tasty. My dad always liked to make stir-fried sticky rice. It's so delicious. It's always a big hit on dinner table. So after the starch, to wrap up the meal would be dessert. Traditionally, it will be like a sweet soup, like red bean sweet soup. But you can also do coconut pudding. So at some banquets, they would serve like a coconut-based sweet soup in the coconut shell too. So it's very similar and equally impressive looking. So soup is very important in this kind of meals. Now let's head off to Chris, and he'll show you how to make it.
So we figured that we could show you how to make an absolutely classic Cantonese soup, lotus root soup. Just dead easy, to a pot of 1.5 liters of water, add in one piece toasted dried octopus. We toasted this over a flame for about a minute each side. If you can't find dried octopus, you could sub in dried squid, or just throw in a handful of dried scallops. We'll also add in 10 pieces dried and aged tangerine peel, one miju sweet date, or you could sub in 3 dried red dates, 250 grams lean pork, blanched for a minute or two, and 500 grams thoroughly cleaned lotus root. We also seem to have forgotten ginger in this batch, but it's best to toss in an inch of crushed ginger as well. Bring that to a boil, then turn your stove down to the lowest it'll go. Cover, and let it cook for 2 hours. 2 hours later, season with 10 grams rock sugar and a half teaspoon of salt. Once those are dissolved into the soup, you're good to go, and you can serve it up.
So you can find all these recipes in the playlist that I've made up here, and I'll also toss the links down in the description. Subscribe for more Chinese cooking videos, and have a happy Year of the Dog.